Hi, this is Alice Bull from scraphappy.org at Creativation 2019. I have come by the Ranger booth and met Simon Hurley. Hi, Simon.
Hi, super nice to meet you guys. I'm here at the Ranger booth introducing my new Simon Hurley Create line, and I'm super excited to share all the products with you guys as well as maybe a demo or two to kind of show them in action.
Okay, now everybody is asking right now, How old is this young man?
I am 16, so I'm pretty young. Got a really awesome start in this industry, and Ranger is the perfect partner to work with.
I am so excited for you.
Thank you so much.
My little niece is 6 years old, and she asked for a camera for Christmas because she wants to be a YouTuber.
That's awesome.
So this is like the dream coming true for someone, and I love it.
Yeah.
I love that you're making it happen.
Like, yeah, definitely.
You're definitely putting the hard work in. I've seen your videos.
it's been quite a while, but it's definitely all worth it. It's a lot of fun, too.
That's amazing. Mm-hmm. So let's get creative. I love it.
Let's get into it. So these are my 12 new dye inks. These are water-reactive ink, and they're super bright and vibrant, which I really love. They're also a felt-based pad, and I wanted to make sure of that so that when you're, you know, pressing against your stamp, you get a really good layer of ink on there, but it's not going to sink into the stamp and kind of bleed your image out. And these, I named them really fun names. So these two are after my two dogs. It's Gur and Woof. One of them growls all the time, no matter if he's happy, sad, anything. And then one of them is more soft-spoken, so I named them Gur and Woof after them. I'll have to share a picture on Instagram or something.
That's super fun.
Yeah, they all have some really fun names. I had a ton of fun when I was naming the colors, but they're really bold, kind of vibrant color palettes. You can create, you know, beautiful looks, but then also pair it with different animals that I've created in the line to really kind of bring out that fun and playful look.
That looks really hard.
That, we're going to show how to make that. It's pretty easy.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah, it's really awesome. So I'll move these off to the side. We'll start working with them in just a second, but I want to go through kind of some of the other products as well. So let's show some of the clear stamp sets. These are high quality photopolymer clear stamps. They're a 6x9 stamp set, and they're a really good retail price too. They retail for about $20, $21, so it's really great to have all these images on that whole set for that great price. They're clear photopolymer made in the USA, which is what you want for card making, and they've got lots of versatility too. So I made them with lots of different critter images, little people, and then you can stamp them inside the astronaut helmets, use these words. They're all separate letters. People keep asking me. They are separate, so you can spell your own fun words out. You can spell out hello, love you, different things like that, and use the O as the space helmet, which is so cool.
So fun.
Mm-hmm. And there's other sets too. So this one has that fun bear and those little kids, different things they can hold on to, and you can create a cool forest scene like that, or, you know, different birthday party scenes or whatever. This one has a trampoline set, and I designed this when I was 11, so it's super awesome to see it come to life with Ranger this year. You can make them all jumping on the trampoline and create a cool interactive card as well.
Well, that's super fun because, like, playing on the trampoline was one of my favorite things to do as a kid. There's, like, I spent a lot of time on the trampoline, and so did my kids, so it's the kind of thing that has a real practical purpose.
Yeah.
It's a lot of backyards with the trampoline in them.
Yeah, so you can give it to kids, or you can use, you know, just the tree by itself. I created a couple of samples with just the tree and did a really cool watercolor background, and then you get a more sophisticated look too, which is perfect. You can use some of the images, you know, for a more sophisticated look, or, you know, go into some of the stamps and get a more playful, fun look.
Excellent.
I know this last one is called Dudes Too. I thought there wasn't enough masculine images in this industry, and if there are, they're either really grungy, which is totally fine. There's a time and place for that for sure. But if you want the clean and simple look, this is definitely for you. So no more putting, you know, that big screwdriver on your nephew's card. You've got some really awesome stamps for them too. So three different heads, three different bodies, a dog, and you can interchange them all. You know, a screwdriver with "You're Driving Me Crazy," a paintbrush with "Dude, I Made You a Card," or you can actually put a card in his hand. So there's lots of different things to customize it for the person you're making it for, which is awesome.
Very playful, and I appreciate that you have made some guy stuff that's not grungy. That's not my style. I like a little sparkle and shine, so it allows me to put my own style into making something for the guys.
Definitely, for sure. So we've got some stencils and stamps too, but I'll share those. Actually, I'll share the stencils right now really quickly.
Cool.
So this is, they're all 6x6, and I made sure to do that just because if you're a card maker, I want to make sure, you know, if you're using, let's say, these ones don't really, you know, have that, but if you want to, you know, use a background stamp, I don't want to decide which way somebody's wood grain goes. So having this 6x6, you can turn it either way, or you can stamp both directions and get a really cool look like that too. So this one is called Backsplash. Super fun with those stars in it. And when I name stuff, you're gonna know that I name it not after the actual design that it is, but just after something that, you know, maybe you find in your house or something that looks like. So this one's called Backsplash, and I absolutely love it. That fine line design. This one is called Flower Builder. So this one's super cool because it's like a stamp layering set, but I wanted to make sure you can get that variety in the images too. So when you blend these, You blend them together and you can use different colors of my inks to kind of create variation in those looks and create some really realistic flowers.
Wow.
And that's the backsplash in the background too, so that stencil is really fun. And these last two are really great for creating scenes as well in your cards. I made them so they kind of pair up with some of the images and critters in some of the stamp sets that I released as well. So there's Stargazer right here, and there's Looks Like Rain. So these are really great for building up backgrounds, doing resist techniques, you know, everything with a stencil. And you can bring these into mixed media too, but they're really meant for card making is what I designed them for, but they'd be really fun with mixed media as well.
Cool.
So let's move on into the stamps as well. These are made by Stampers Anonymous, and they did a fantastic job at making these. So here's the big graphic plaid, and I wanted to make sure that the printing is on the back here. Some of them are just gray usually, but I wanted mine with printing on the back so that if people just leave the acetate on, they can store them just like this and flip through their stamps and it's perfect. And their red rubber is really high quality as well.
Cool.
So we've got the wood grain, which is called splintered. We've got the classic flannel. Then we have Flower Garden, which is super fun. I love those bold flower designs. And then we also have the painted lines, which you can stamp vertically, horizontally, or both to create a grid pattern, which is super cool.
Cool.
Now let's move on into a technique as well. So I'm going to go into my cardstock. This is my stark white cardstock. Now I've cut it down into a smaller piece. It actually comes in 8.5 by 11. So you can cut it down into whatever you want, but I wanted 8.5 by 11 so you can cut it down into, you know, whatever kind of card you wanted to make. Really easily accessible, or you could use the whole sheet. Maybe give an art journal page or something cool like that as well. So we've got this card size piece, and I'm going to do some really quick ink blending. So let's start off with Bee Sting. I love these names of these colors. So I'm going to go inside of that ink there, and I'm going to go in with a Ranger Mini Ink Blending Tool and just blend on some color.
I'm a little worried that this is named Bee Sting through personal experience.
Yeah, you know, when the bee sting gets red and kind of swells up, that's what this color is. It's that nice, bright red color. It's really kind of a beautiful tone, but the name is really, really awesome. I love it. So, I'm just going to kind of apply lots of color onto there. If there's any harsh marks on the edges, I'm going to blend those out in just a second with some other colors, so you'll be able to see those kind of disappear as well. Just going in here, doing some awesome blending, and then I'm going to go in with Slippery When Wet. This is a nice bright yellow, based off those fun signs you see. So I'm going to move into here, and we're going to overlap it. And since these are translucent dye inks, what that's going to do is it's going to create a nice orange right in between there.
Cool.
So it really creates an awesome color in between there, and you really get a great effect.
You don't need to necessarily have as many colors at your fingertips able to make some really cool stuff.
Yeah, definitely. It's really awesome if you want to start out and really try the inks. Definitely go for these. I'm going to show you another color, too, that works well with these two. And it creates really cool backgrounds. Now, you're not going to get, you know, all the shades and varieties that you would get, but you really do get some cool looks if you want to.
Sometimes we start a collection, mm-hmm. and then we grow it over time, and that way we know how to kind of
definitely
fudge that effect so it looks like we got a bigger stash.
Mm-hmm, for sure. So like blending like this with different colors and kind of mixing in between with these dye inks, because they're translucent, they give you that really awesome, you know, variety of colors. So we're going with Clear Skies. This is a really nice bright and beautiful blue. And what's nice about this is, look, I'm going into that yellow and we're creating a green color. And then I'll go into that red too, and we're going to create a nice dark purple.
They're blending so beautifully.
Thank you so much. Yeah, they really do a great job of blending on the surface and creating those colors in between that are really beautiful. So I'm just going in here, really creating that blend. If there's any harsh marks, I'm not going to worry about it right now. If you wanted to, you can go back in with other colors and continue to blend them to get a really smooth blend. But I'm just going kind of quick right now because we're going to kind of cover this up in just a second. We're just really going for a nice laydown of color here.
These are very vibrant. When you said that they're vibrant colors,
they're bold.
Like, they're, oh, they're beautiful.
Thank you so much. I wanted to start out with those bold colors to kind of go along with the playful style of this, because they really pair together nicely with those different stamps that I released as well. If you want to do kind of a more subtle look, you definitely can, you know, go for that really nice, beautiful look as well. But if you want to go for a more playful, a fun look, they really pair nicely with the stamps.
Cool.
So we'll go in with Triple Berry here. This is that beautiful purple color. It's really nice and rich. That beautiful color right there. And I'm just going to add that and keep blending it in here. Blending right into all these colors, and they all do blend really nicely together. So you just kind of choose whatever colors, and since they're all those kind of mid-tones, they're all really bright like that, it's gonna blend super nicely. So I'm just going in, finishing all this off. And I really want to lay down a lot of color for this technique, because you want to kind of lift off that color. We're going to do that in a second. And so having all that color down is going to help us lift them off in just a second here. So again, if you wanted to take more time, you definitely could and really blend all those together. But let's move on to stamping.
You showed how easy that it was to create. So it's very possible that even I could do it.
Yeah, definitely. Anybody can do it. It's pretty simple with the blending tools and really easy to apply that ink. So I'm going in with that flower garden background stamp, which is so fun. And I'm going to go in with the Distress Sprayer. Now, this is kind of important to this technique because it gives a really fine mist. Some sprayers don't. And this is going to just mist right over top of the stamp. And it just gets that fine mist over top of the whole stamp. So you can barely even see some of those, you know, drops on there, which is really what we want. So I'm going to go in here then. I'll set this right on top of that floral background there. We're going to give light pressure to this whole thing. You don't want to give too much pressure because if you do, it kind of squeezes that water out and it gets rid of some of that detail in there.
You want to kind of give it a chance to soak in a little bit.
Mm-hmm. So just pressing, making sure that it touches all the areas on the stamp. And then look at that.
Oh.
It starts reacting right away, but as it keeps going, you'll keep kind of lifting off some of that color and get that lighter color on there as well, which is so beautiful. So look at that awesome background.
That's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. And on the packaging, too, we also added that lighter color right there. So that's what it's going to look like once it kind of wipes off with that color and lifts off of that surface. So it creates that really ghosted look on there. And also, if you wanted to go for a more playful look, this is kind of a more, you know, different kind of mixed media, grungy kind of look. And you just add a little sentiment onto here. So you can really go for whatever you want when you're creating a background like this.
Yeah. That looks beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Simon.
Yeah, definitely. No problem. It was awesome to have you guys here.
So when are your products actually hitting the stores? Where can people get them? Like,
okay,
what do we know?
So my products are releasing in February, so they'll be shipping then. And then you can get them in your favorite online retailers. I know scrapbook.com is going to carry them, which is super cool. And different local retailers, too. So be sure to ask your favorite local retailer if they want to carry Simon Hurley Create products. And I'm sure they'll get them in for you, which is really exciting.
That's awesome. And can you give your YouTube channel a plug?
Yeah, definitely. My YouTube channel is Inklipse. It's Inklipse, or you can find me at just Simon Hurley. If you search that up, you'll find me there as well.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you so much for stopping by.
That's great. This is Alice Bull from scraphappy.org at the Ranger booth with Simon Hurley. Say your handwriting is a lot tidier than my boys.
Yeah, I actually lettered some of these stamps, so like that right there I lettered too. So it's a little bit neater, but when I'm doing it in all caps, it's not as nice. Thank you so much.
That's so great.
Thanks, yeah.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll do 1, 2, 3. Say your handwriting is a lot tidier than my boys.
Yeah, I actually lettered some of these stamps, so like that right there I lettered too. So it's a little bit neater, but when I'm doing it in all caps, it's not as nice. Thank you so much.
That's so great.
Thanks, yeah.
Thank you.